Narcissists are weird, am I right? Well, that's been my experience anyway, and I know that several other survivors have told me they've experienced something similar. So I polled this fan group, and I asked them very specifically, what's the weirdest thing you've ever seen your narcissist do? Well, their answers might surprise you. I ended up with so many answers that I'm actually gonna have to make 3 or 4 videos out of this. So for today's video, we're gonna focus on 55 weird things that narcissists do to gain control, get attention, and manipulate us. So let's get started.
Closed captioning provided by Athena Moberg and CPTSDFoundation.org.
If you're new around here, then I'll tell you, my name's Angie Atkinson, and on this channel, I offer free daily video coaching to help you discover, understand, and overcome narcissistic abuse in toxic relationships. I like to call it toxic relationship rehab. So if that sounds good to you, hit that subscribe button and we'll just get going. So we're just gonna jump right into it. Now, before I do, let me remind you, these are not my thoughts, these are not my ideas. These are the ideas and the thoughts of the survivors who are part of the Spanily. Now, there will be more, as I said, to this series, but for today's video and any video like this that I do, you'll hear different pronouns being used, you'll hear different types of sexuality discussed, and you'll hear different types of relationships. In fact, in today's bunch, there's a bunch of different weird narcissist mother things as well. So, take a look.
Number one, does unexplained maniacal laughing count? Like, he would pass behind me as I helped my son with homework. Then, maniacal laughter. Left me like, did I say something? Number two, he didn't want to talk about whatever it was I wanted to talk about, so he punished me with silent treatment. But for me, it was sometimes too important what I had to talk about, so I went to him after a few hours and I wanted to continue the talk. It never worked out well. Number three, sometimes he was raging and beat himself constantly with his fists against his head. I find this very weird and it scared me. Number four, saying they hate fill in the blank, but you are that thing. And they always pick that in a partner just so they can say, I hate that. Number five, telling me I'm old and nobody wants an old washed out hag. I'm 41. He was doing me this grand favor by just being with me at all. I honestly think I look a little younger than I actually am, but getting old frightens me, especially after being told for years that my only good quality was being somewhat attractive. Number six, mine would also make it a favor by being with me because no one else was trying as hard as him. I had to tell him that I'm not the one who can't stand to be alone. I don't need anyone. That was him projecting on me since he couldn't stand to be alone and needs a constant supply of people. Number seven, complaining about people who forgot their birthday and didn't donate for so-and-so race, etc. Getting pissed and saying, I did this, so I should get this. And if I don't, you don't get anything. I found that weird and strange. A person can be that rude. Number eight, would say XYZ to me, and when I would call him out on it, he'd legit straight face say, I never said that. Number nine, when he found out I was pregnant, he told me I wasn't allowed to tell anyone. But then he went back and consulted with this guy to find out what herbs he could sneak into my tea to induce miscarriage. And he tried to bribe me into having an abortion by saying he'd pay to have me fly to visit my friends in the USA to quote-unquote get over it. Number 10. Somebody hit the car from behind and he blamed me for the accident. I was at a light sitting perfectly still when a car crossed the lane from a gas station and scraped the back of my car. Number 11. When I was married to this narcissist, our last year together, I started to have nervous breakdowns. I started crying a lot. I can't breathe after screaming. I thought I was losing my mind and I doubted my sanity. Now you're going to ask me where the weird thing is. Well, he used to record videos when I'm having these breakdowns. He filmed the 5 times I had them without trying to help me. And the second day he comes and shows me the videos. Look at yourself and how funny you were yesterday. Number 12 is a continuation of number 11. When I asked for a divorce, he said, I don't want to leave you, but if you'll ask for a divorce, I'll show these videos of you to the judge. Number 13, locking the room the thermostat is in, freezing and or overheating everyone in the house. Number 14, claims to have been offered commercials because she's so good at driving right down the middle of lanes. Number 15, he wanted me to be friends with all of his old girlfriends, but I wasn't allowed to have male friends, even the ones I've known since 4th grade. Number 16, the weirdest thing my narc ever did was to tell me that her pastor said to stay in contact with those you don't talk to anymore, and tells me she's been reaching out to this one guy she went to high school with, that I even know it's a guy who wanted me to go out with her. She denied him due to distance. Ever since we got back together, I had to find out she's been making fake accounts trying to reach him, and as a result, He blocked her every time. So he may know something I didn't, or know who she was. That, or hated rejection and moved on. But the fact she told me that she'd been doing that made me feel like I'm getting dumped. Not like I care, but the fact that she wanted to do that made me feel like second choice. So he went no contact, and now I'm 100% no contact. Number 17. With me, he was strong and seductive, but the minute he was with his friends, he became this little boy, trying to impress them. With them, I don't think he feels powerful. Number 18. He told me that if I didn't make him number one, he would destroy me. Number 19. He liked to argue and fight in bed. Then he told me to get out of bed, and when I wouldn't, he would roll me off the mattress onto the floor. Literally pick up the mattress and roll me off into the floor. That's what I call weird. Number 20, keep me up all night arguing. Number 21, mine once told me to take off my ring. When I did, he started shouting for me to put it back on or else. All of this is in the middle of the night. Number 22, my narcissist used to take pictures of damage to the house that either he caused himself or small things like me throwing a picture frame on the floor after he abused me and called me crazy and told me to throw it. He would take pictures, then call the police and tell them to look and see what she did. Number 23. He was eating Cheetos while we were watching a movie. I was hungry watching him eat, and every 15 minutes or so, he would give me one Cheeto, like I was a puppy. Number 24. When I refused to engage him at our Airbnb, the last big fight, the one where he argued with himself for hours, he started unplugging the whole outlet that the TV was hooked up to because I was being rude and not making eye contact, even though I told him numerous times before that I wasn't engaging with him, and it's rude of him to keep trying when I've clearly set my boundary. Number 25. He would hide my medications, money, jewelry, all of it from me, and say I must have lost them. Then, in a week, he would let me have them back, laughing at the thought that he was making me crazy. Number 26. I had thought I was really losing my mind, how often I would lose the thing I just had. I finally realized he was doing this on purpose when I pulled out my driver's license to go renew it, walked to get my purse to leave, and the license wasn't on the table where I had just left it. He was sitting next to that table and I asked him if he saw it. Of course not. I'd never leave anything there. After several frantic minutes, tears and crying, I was losing my mind, during which time he in no way tried to comfort or help his wife, who he could see and hear was on the edge of a nervous breakdown, even wondering if I should renew my license. I was so mental. I walked back to the table and there it was, of course. When asked, he said, "It was there all the time. I don't know why you were carrying on. Are you crazy or something?" When I asked, "Why didn't you help me?" I was ignored. That's when I realized the answer wasn't that I was crazy, but that something was wrong with a man who could not hear his wife having a breakdown and not try to help her. No empathy. Number 27 would slap me across the face, and when I asked why he did that, he would say, "What are you talking about?" Number 28, I would come home from work, get in bed, and try to turn the TV to something I wanted to watch. He would be pretending to be asleep. As soon as I turned the channel, he would yell at me and say he was listening to that. Sometimes he would actually be asleep and wake up. As soon as I turned the channel, he'd wake up screaming to turn the channel back. Number 29, saying, "You're fat," but they have the issue with weight and body image. Same with acne or other health issues. Number 30, just leaving, not telling you a damn thing, showing up days later like nothing happened. Number 31. Mine is well over 400 pounds, but calls everyone else fat and gross. Tells me that I'm health obsessed, and that's worse than being overweight. Oh, I could go on. Number 32. Looked me in the eyes and told me that we would never have to worry about money again because he had piles stashed of cash everywhere around the house. The mattress, the shed, buried out back. He said he'd hidden it in places I would never think of. Number 33. Threw everything that was in our freezer and fridge on the front lawn. It was what we came home to after the police station because she threw a brick through the back windshield of the car and we said, "We aren't going back until you pick her up." And that was what we found. A front lawn full of frozen TV dinners and groceries. Number 34. Call his mother on his cell phone in the middle of giving me two black eyes. "Mom," he says frantically, "she's hysterical. I can't get her to shut up." I was screaming because he had his booted foot on my head with all of his weight on it. Do you want to know what his mother said to him after he put his cell on speaker so I could hear? "Take that bitch to the nearest bus stop and drop her off." Number 35. My mother-in-law? She loved me like her own daughter, but she was proud of him for not killing me long ago. Number 36. He was angry that his mother didn't breastfeed him. Number 37. He would breathe in my breaths. It felt like he was stealing my soul. Number 38. Narcissists argue with themselves for hours on end. Number 39, when narcissists try to smear campaign via law enforcement, and then they portray themselves as a victim. Number 40, steal jewelry from me over the course of weeks and then slowly put it back. Number 41, when his dad remarried and had children with her, he, 30 years old, lost it, saying his dad is a better dad to those kids and he'll never accept them as his brothers because they are quote-unquote halfies, half-brothers, half-Hispanic, etc. A grown man talking about babies in such a way. Very disturbing. Number 42. As we were driving on the freeway, he took my cell phone and threw it out of the car, pushed the door open, then pushed me out and left me there along the highway in another state. He eventually came back, but it was my fault that I made him do that. Number 43. Wants me to pay for any and everything he wants, from books, my gifts, $1 million home, only live in summer, hotels when he goes alone, shares his business, worthless, pay half his rent, quote unquote, when I visit, pay deposit on a flat for us, pay for transfers to airport because he decided to go home, pay for airport parking when I waited 7 hours at arrivals because he was refused entry to the country, accused me of trespassing if I stayed later in the morning and didn't leave the hotel room at the same time as him, never has rang me long distance to talk, and one time I answered his long distance call, gave me a bollocking for answering the call. Thousands of weird examples. Number 44, break up with me because I didn't give him a hug. Number 46, he thinks he's so gorgeous. He's 40 and prides himself on how well he fits in with 20-year-olds, his own daughter's age. Number 47, she got mad that I had my bicycle in the shared space of the apartment for a few days. So did she with her bicycle, but we all know that what's okay for them isn't really okay for us. So she took all of her items out of her bedroom and closet and piled them in front of my door. You know, since it's shared space. Number 48. We had 2 fish aquariums. One huge one for our Oscars and one for my parrotfish that I had to rescue from the tank with the Oscars because they were trying to kill her. He saw me use the water test strips to test the water in my aquarium one day, so he hid them so that I couldn't use them without asking him. He also hid all of the batteries from me and doled them out as he saw fit. Weirdo. Number 49. Took his mistress with him to events for our business while I stayed home looking after our baby and pets. We are pretty well known in our industry, so it was very risky for him. So I'm surprised he risked my finding out he was cheating. I guess he thought he had me fooled, so I wouldn't believe it even if I did find out. Number 50. Ran outside with his stupid handgun every time someone passed by the house or a tire would backfire. Weird. Said he was going to call the police when he was leaving me, and I grabbed his arm. Weird. Number 51. When I called because I was sick at work, he deleted all of my calls. I missed one call because a call came through in between, and he tried to convince me that I had not called him. When I confronted him with his online cheating, he tried to tell me that someone had stolen his identity and then erased history from his laptop as I was finding it. Number 52. Went to the hospital over nothing. Number 53. Talk about himself constantly around my family. Told his kids things about me and his ex, things they shouldn't know. Packed up his son's room when I went away one weekend and took everything over to his ex's house. Ugh. He said he thought I was going to leave. Flipped out because someone posted a picture of Colin Firth on my Facebook wall and blasted me, saying people would think he, the narc, isn't good enough for me. This was right before a trip I was taking with my family, without him. Number 54. Jump out of the car at a red light and not answer the phone when I asked him how he wanted me to make his food. Number 55. He allowed his friend to verbally abuse me, and when he did absolutely nothing to defend me and told his friend he's sorry I always cause problems, I started crying, so he instantly played the victim and curled up in a ball on the floor and started to cry himself and pretended I was going to hit him.
This brings me to the question of the day. The question of the day is, have you experienced any of these things, and what kind of weird things did your narcissist do? Share your thoughts, share your ideas, share your experiences in the comment section below. And let's talk about it. All right, that's all I've got for you right now. But as always, thank you so much for being a part of my day and a part of my life. And hey, thanks for letting me be a part of yours. It really does mean a lot to me. Now, before I go, make sure you take a look at the videos I'm leaving for you over there. And while you're here, hit that subscribe button right down there so we can stay connected and continue on this healing journey together. I'll see you soon.